Oh no, I don't have follow notification set up because like I used to. It was really funny back then. The reason I don't have it anymore is because as a streamer, once we get used to a certain amount of follows, and if we stream the next day and we don't get that same amount, we will really feel some type of way about ourselves. Like at least for me, right? You know, like back then I was really used to like getting like 10 follows a day or 5 or 6. And there was like an entire 2 stretch of weeks where I didn't get a single follow. I think it could be just the game I'm playing, or everyone could be watching like League of Legends World Cup or some shit like that. But I took it personally, right? Like, oh, I didn't get enough follows. So it was like a really bad mental thing to keep track of. So that's why I turn off the notification. And that's why once I'm done with my stream, I don't even check to see like who followed me, because it affects me. If 20 people follow me, I'll be super hyped. But what if nobody follows me that day, right? And I streamed for 8 hours. I was like doing it. I was like fucking entertaining. And also, there's another reason why. So this happened like, I think, a year ago, and I was streaming Death Stranding for the first time, and a lot of trolls would actually write the spoiler of the game as their name. They would be like, so-and-so died, or so-and-so is the bad guy, or whatever, right? And when they follow you, their name would flash across the screen. Everyone would see it, the streamer, the viewers, and it would really, really suck. Yeah, what a bunch of a-holes, right? So that happens, right? Yeah, I don't really see a good reason to have follow notification on. And to be honest, like, once you reach a certain size, like, you notice, like, big streamers don't have follow notifications because they don't really care. You know, personally, I really appreciate if you follow my channel, and I can thank you personally if you type in chat, but you know, I try not to think about follows anymore. Because like, you know, as a streamer, you can't help but have projections, right? Like, oh, you know, like, by the end of this month, I'm gonna hit this amount of followers on Twitch. Yo, by the end of this year, we're gonna hit like 3,000 followers total, you know? And that's not healthy. You know, like everyone else, when I first start streaming, like, I wanna make it, right? Sometimes if you do things for the wrong reason, you won't make it very far. Like, initially, when I first started doing this, I thought about the money, I thought about the fame. But when you don't see any of that in the first few days, in the first few weeks, in the first few months, or years, you're probably gonna quit. That means, like, if you keep thinking of those things to, like, power you through, you're most likely gonna fail. Because those things will never come in time. Right, you gotta find something else that you love. Love more than money, love more than fame, love more than all of that. And I think if you love those things more, it will keep you coming back to streaming. Because like, I am really on the verge of getting burned out, to be honest. I think I've been doing this for 3 years. I think part of my burnout comes from not having any games that are good. Because today I actually tried Resident Evil Revelations and Resident Evil 5, and they were both so shitty that I had to come back to Resident Evil 1. You know what I mean? It's really hard to get the right things. And the problem is also like having to renew your, like, you know, like when you get married to someone, you got to renew your marriage vows, right? Because like every few years, you know, things change. So it's the same with streaming. I feel is you got to renew that shit, because eventually it can feel a little old. If you enjoy my content, make sure you comment, like, subscribe, all that jazz. Check out my Twitch on OatsCurryTV, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.